With the holiday season right around the corner, I thought it might be helpful to put together a quick video showing you guys some of my favorite stocking stuffers for woodworkers. These are all tools that I've had for several years that, well, I'll say a lot of them I actually carry in my apron because I use them all the time. To make it simple for you, I also linked all these products below. So if you are shopping for that woodworker in your life, I have the links below so you can check those items out for yourself. Now, the need to do this actually stemmed from a conversation with my wife. She never knows what to get me, and when I actually showed her this list, her first response was, "Where the heck was this list 5 years ago?" So let's get into it. One of the first things I think we need to start with is safety, because, you know, safety first. Before I wore glasses, I actually had these, and these are a safety glass that are made by Migrid, I believe is how you say it, which they're super lightweight, very comfortable. They do have protective guards or shields or whatever on the side. And to be honest, I actually don't mind the way they look. I'm gonna be more inclined to wear something that I actually like the look of and is comfortable than something that is big and bulky and looks like my shop teacher from the 80s would have worn. The second item on my list is easily one of my favorite tape measures of all time, and that's the FastCap left to right tape measure. This is a 25 foot version, I believe, and here's two features of it that I think are absolutely the reason why any woodworker at any level should pick up. The first one is it actually has all the fractions printed on it. So if you are a beginner and you're trying to learn how to read a tape measure, this becomes a bit of a cheat sheet so you can learn the fractions and be a lot quicker with the tape measure. The second is, and this comes from, well, being left-handed, is the tape measure can be read from left to right. This is a really smart function of this tape measure, and I have several of these. I think I have two 16 foots and one of these 25 foots, and they're kind of scattered around my shop. And of course, this one just sits in my apron. Having a precise measurement is one thing, but making sure you're marking it on your materials is another. And kind of the first step in that I find the most helpful is a mechanical pencil. As opposed to, for instance, a regular pencil where it's actually really easy to break the tip off when you're moving around, if it's in your apron or if you drop it, it doesn't take much to break it, then you have to go sharpen it. So I find a mechanical pencil, which also has a lot finer tip, is a great way to go. If you want to go one step further in making sure that you're making the most accurate measurements as possible, I would say you also want to look at some kind of a scribing knife. A scribing knife like this one right here is extremely sharp, but it gives you a very precise line that you're able to mark out. So if you're doing any kind of butterfly keys or cutting any joinery, this gives you the ability to mark precisely to a line, and then you can actually come back and fill in with your pencil, and that is very easy to cut to or to chisel back to. So like I said earlier, I don't see as well as I used to, so that's why I now wear glasses. And a lot of the work that I do is with walnut. You've probably seen this. So seeing pencil on walnut, I find doesn't show up as well as if I'm using something that has more of a contrast. So that's why I started using these Pico markers. And this has basically a refillable colored cartridge. I can't call it lead because it's not lead. And this shows up really well against walnut. My favorite color is the white. The white on the walnut seems to pop the most. One of my favorite features about this is because it is a little bit thicker, it does have a pencil sharpener built right into the base. So I'm not running around trying to sharpen this when I'm working. This works amazing if you haven't seen these before. If you've been around my channel for a while, you know that Rockler has been a big supporter of what I do. And before I was working with Rockler, one of the first things that I bought myself were these bench cookies. They have a non-slip surface on the top and bottom, and they're designed just so you can get them up off your workbench. So if you're doing any pattern routing or adding some kind of a detail to your routing or even sanding, your material piece will not slide around and you have a safe distance off your bench to be able to work. My design style in woodworking usually has landed more towards angles as opposed to just straight 90s. And sometimes when I have to set up my miter saw or maybe my table saw for a very precise angle, I usually go for this. And this is a digital angle finder. This is a really neat tool. It actually has a magnetic base. So it allows me to zero it out on my table saw, magnetically attach it to my saw blade, and then rotate the arbor on my table saw to get it to the exact angle that I need to in order to make the cut that I need. Having a mechanical way to find an angle is also super helpful. This is one of my favorites. It is another digital angle finder, and it has a mechanical mechanism to be able to find an angle. And you know what? This one you could use to set up a table saw or your miter saw as well. It's just as convenient as the one that is magnetic. So between the two, I would say lean towards this one first as opposed to this one. So when I'm drilling holes, the first thing I usually reach for is this. And this is a set from Rockler. It's a countersink set that is so incredibly smart. The way that this works is it allows you to take your countersink bit so you can drill your countersink hole, and allows you to take a sleeve which holds a driver bit and use them in combination together all in one drill. So you're not carrying around two drills when you're doing a job. You're able to chuck up your driver bit as well as use your countersinking bit all in one set. And this comes in a really neat carrying case. I'm surprised I've kept it actually together because I do use this all the time. And it's something that definitely I would recommend for anyone that is even doing home renovations, but of course for furniture building as well. So to drill the most accurate holes, it's always good to use a center punch. This is one that I've had for so long, very inexpensive, and it's something that is, again, always in my shop apron. This allows me to measure out exactly where I want my drill bit to start. I can mark a hole, and the drill naturally just goes towards that as it has an indent already started in the material, and the drill bit doesn't wander as much. When I'm doing glue ups, the one thing I always reach for, other than glue, is one of these. And these are silicone glue brushes. The great thing about these silicone brushes is cleanup is a snap. All you have to do is let the glue dry, and I've done this with epoxy as well, but you let your glue dry, and afterwards you're able to just chip it out, and you have a clean brush ready for the next glue up. In combination with this, you'll always see me using one of the silicone glue mats. The glue mats are something that might not maybe make the list as far as fitting into a stocking, but it's definitely something that I strongly recommend. Besides using this for gluing, I also quite often use the mats when I'm sanding just to have a bit of friction underneath the piece that I am working on. One of the things that I brought into my shop a couple years ago was this Starbond CA glue. And this is a CA glue. This one in particular is a medium brown. So if I'm filling any knot holes or anything, I'm able to use this in combination with what's called activator to quickly fill knot holes and be able to sand those back. It's also extremely helpful for building quick and easy jigs. And in some cases where I just need to do some pattern routing, I can use the blue tape trick and just be able to hold my template onto the piece that I'm working on without marring the surface, just with CA glue. I will point out that there's a discount coupon below, so if you're looking to buy any of this, I've posted a link to one of my favorite products from Starbond, and there's a discount that you can use as well if you're looking to purchase any of this. If you made it this far, I got a bonus one for you, and that's this. This is a brass setup block set. Now these are machined to very precise measurements. So for instance, if you had to do a reveal on a drawer face, it's very simple to use a 1/8 inch spacer to be able to measure all that out. That way you're not trying to get in there and measure out and mark with a tape measure at the same time. These are extremely precise. I use them all the time on my table saw, and as I said, as well for drawer setups and other setups where it just makes way more sense to have a physical object as opposed to trying to use a tape measure. Down below, I have linked all these products. Hopefully you found some value in this. If there's stuff that I missed, because I'm sure I did, make sure you comment below so the people that are finding this video for the first time and shopping for that woodworker in their life, they can go through the comments and see some suggestions from you. Any combination of these objects, I think any woodworker in your life would super appreciate seeing in their stocking or even underneath the tree. If you found value in this video, would you please hit that thumbs up button? This just lets other people that are looking for this kind of content know that this is a video that others did find helpful. And if I've earned it, I would also love to see you subscribe. I've got lots of things planned for next year and a couple more surprises up my sleeve for the end of this year. For however you celebrate at this time of year, I really would just like to say happy holidays and looking forward to seeing you more in the new year. So dirty. Quite often I'll reach for, where'd it go? Now. Okay. You can do this. I can do this. Appreciated. if you subscribe to this channel. No,